Hey folks, welcome back to Last Words Workshop. Today we're going to be modifying a pair of steeplejacks for you. So we're going to start off with a basic pattern. I'm going to show you the adjustments I'm making to custom fit it for a customer. So I'm going to go select the pattern over here, which we're going to use as our base. One of our steeplejacks. There we go. And we'll go ahead and lay this out, and then we'll explain roughly what we're going to do. So here's a pair of steeplejacks. This is what they look like in the standard version. This is what we're going to be basing this pattern on. There's going to be a whole bunch of modifications to it. Basically, some of the points we're going to show you on here in terms of what's being changed is the way in which the back is constructed. We have a belt loop and a couple of yokes in the back here. We're changing the depth of the crotch here, and we're also going to be changing the width of the hip and reshaping the hip a certain amount. And we're going to be lengthening the calf panel, so they're actually going to run up higher on this one. So we have all the pattern pieces laid out here on the table, and I can show you what we're going to be starting with. This is the back belt loop, these are the back yokes. We're reshaping the hips, so those have to go. This is the calf, that's being changed, so that has to go. This is the front thigh panel, but as we're changing the shape of the leg a little bit up in here, that's all going to change too, so that goes. Here's the front belt loop, but I'm also narrowing the waistband on this particular set, so we don't use that either. Here's the original waistband, which is pretty much going at this point because we're reshaping the waist and the hip. The pocket needs to be redone as well because the hip line is changing. And that leaves us with the front and back leg pieces. So all this can go. And I'll roll out some fabric here. Fabric? Paper! We make patterns out of paper here. Long arms are essential in pattern drafting. Now we're going to go ahead, trace out these two pieces, and do our modifications. And then what we'll do is we'll rebuild all those other pattern pieces we just got rid of, using some of them as a base, and some of them we'll just redraft from scratch on this here. So we can go ahead and stop filming for a second while I trace it out, and we'll be right back with a pattern that we're going to start working on. So I've traced out the back leg here. In fact, I'm going to be developing the back leg first and then working the front leg from it, because there's going to be some changes in the shape of it and the hip, and it's easier to carry that across to a new front piece as well. So we're basically just starting with the back leg panel on this pattern. So now you can see the lines that are marked out there. They're a little faint. It's just in light pencil. I'm going to start using a marker as we go along so you can see really clearly what I'm doing. But for now, my less permanent lines are going to be like that. So I'm just going to throw in a few lines for balance. Give me some idea of the overall length I'm working to. We're aiming for a total outseam length of here of about 40 inches. And knock that there off. And we're going to be raising some other points up. The actual waistline mem is staying the same, but I'm going to be changing the shape of the curve here along the crotch seam. I'm going to be raising the crotch seam up a little bit. And we're also going to be reshaping the outside of the hip here a little, rotating a little out from the inside leg, and obviously this is going to be the total length of the leg, and we're actually going to aim for, I think, a 14-inch calf. The leg length itself is going to get quite a lot shorter too. It's going to be a little bit more like sort of a jodhpur look with these ones, but it should be interesting to see how it comes out. So, where's the rest of my information? It is okay. Got to have lots of different rulers for pattern making. Lots and lots of different rulers. What I'm doing is I'm just creating some nice lines at right angles, which give me a good idea of roughly where I want things to go. And I'm working this all out. I have a measured crotch depth from the client of 8 inches. I'm going to add in 1 inch on there for ease. We're raising this up so that she gets better mobility and can move around more easily. The lower the crotch seam, obviously, if you try to raise your legs, it's going to pull down there on that fabric between the legs. So we're raising that up a little bit to make it easier to move around. It's also going to rebalance the shape of the leg a little bit because we're shortening the whole thing up. And it's going to make it look like the bottom of the crotch is right between our knees if we don't raise that up. And it's going to allow me to reshape the whole back of this and put in a lot more ease back here. So at this point, I'm just going to roughly sketch in a few lines I want to work with shape-wise. So I'm going to stop talking and start drawing right now, and you can kind of follow along, and then I'll explain what I've done towards the end. So here we have the new outline. You can see that compared to where the original length of the leg came down to, we've taken up quite a lot. It's about 5 3/4 inches or so. This here is going to be sort of the full length of the thing. Down to here will be the 40 inches outseam, up from the top of the waistband down there to here. And then that 14 inch long calf, which we're going to do, is going to come right up to here. And I figure about 6 inches is about how much of a overlap I like. That's going to be 3 inches to sort of fall down and then tuck back up past the calf based upon the customer's outseam length. So it's going to get that sort of nice blousing at the top, still show a lot of the calf, and still retain the kind of advantages you have from having extra long legs on the steeplejacks, which give you all of that freedom of movement. So we can see I've redrawn the legs quite a lot. This here is the old line. Obviously I've narrowed it in to fit the customer's calf measurements, which are a little bit smaller than the standard steeplejacks. Here's the old line coming up along here, a little bit wider there, so I've tailored it a little bit. This particular customer, I know she likes to wear her steeplejacks right up at her natural waistline, so I'm tapering this curve in slightly and then pulling it out again. It's going to rest more comfortably at the waist through the hip that way, and stay where she wants them without having to worry about a belt or suspenders or anything like that for the most part. And then we've redrafted the curve of the waist wing up a little bit higher in back, and obviously the main difference here is going to be how we've redrafted the back half of the crotch seam here. You can see the original line comes around here, and here's our new line, and then back down to the leg again. You can see we've extended a little bit further here to add a little bit more room in the crotch, even though we've taken up the crotch depth there by about whatever that is, 3 inches or so. And here's the old line from the leg coming down here, and you can see the new line in here. A few things which I did, obviously I got some working lines here to establish, you know, so squared off the original curve in the crotch seam so I could raise it up more easily, and it just gives me a nice corner that I'm working into, helps me shape that line by eye. Most of this is definitely more on the art rather than science side of things. I know a few key measurement points that I need to hit, like the width of the waist, how deep this here is going to be, and that's what I'm marking off with these straight lines, where the center line balance for the garment is, how wide the leg opening is going to be down here at the bottom. That sort of stuff is things which have to meet certain specifications. The rest of it, it's really just me going by eye, something you learn over time. So what I've just done here is I've taken the original yoke pieces from the original pattern, and I've just laid them down on top of my lines from the original pattern here. This one's inset because it has the seam allowance in there. None that's marked on here, I just know what it is. And here he is, match up to the hip on the outside. So what I've done is I've taken both of these pieces here, and then I've traced those lines onto the pattern, so that gives me an idea where the original yoke is. And what we can see is this one here, because we've raised up the back a little bit at the center back, is now lower than it should be, and it's hitting too much into the curve, so it needs to be raised up where this here is pretty much straight, otherwise I'm not going to be able to have a yoke that works. And I have to decide whether or not I want to drop out one of those yokes altogether, or perhaps reshape them in a more interesting way. But these here are on there to give me a guideline for how I'm going to do that. So I'm going to go ahead and revise the lines of where that yoke's going to be, and we'll get back in a second when we've done that. Okay, so here we are, the line which I've chosen. I'm going to go with just one yoke because two of them are going to get too cluttered, given that we have to, you know, basically lost 4 inches or so of space to put the yokes into here. So this one here we're going to go, we've got a slight curve to it, which I think is going to balance nicely with the new line of the waist, to give a little bit more sweep to the back of it, make it just, you know, slightly more feminine on this particular pair. And then you'll see this here's got a little bit thicker looking line. That's because I've had to go and straighten this off here and then re-square off the angle on the top of the waist there, because this piece here
here is going to be mirrored in this direction here for the final pattern piece. So obviously it needs to be straight along here, and I want to have this at a right angle at the top, otherwise you're going to end up, when the piece is mirrored, having a little sort of dint come in. You can see what that would look like. You'd have this strange kind of curve in and then curve out that way. And we don't want that to happen. Lastly, what I've done is I've just started to trace in the new line of the waistband. I'm going to just trace that onto a scrap piece of paper for reference when I come to redrafting the waistband. But as I'm going to be tracing out this panel and then cutting out the back leg to make the front leg, I want to have a reference of what that shape should look like, which I can trace more easily. So there it is. Okay, on to the next stage, and that's going to be tracing out this back panel here, and then we'll cut out the back leg and start work on the front leg. So here we are, we have the new back yoke drafted on here. One of the things which I did after I shut off last was add in the center back seam allowance here. We got a 3/4 inch seam because we're using a flat felt in the back there. So obviously you want to mark that off because you don't want to use this as the fold line, you want to use this here as the fold line for this piece. And then you can see we have the seam allowance marked in along this bottom edge here, because while the outside of this pattern still has the seam allowance basically from the original pattern piece attached to it, obviously this piece doesn't, and this is a fold edge, so we know to add that in. So there's our new back yoke ready to go. Next thing to do, we're going to cut out this leg piece here, and we'll start tracing out for the front leg.
So we've traced out the back leg now, and we're going to start turning into the front leg. And I'm going to show you a few things which I've done in terms of laying out lines, and give you a bit of an explanation why. So once again, what I've done is created myself some guidelines for it. I'm basically going to keep the profile of the outside of the leg exactly the same. I don't see any reason to change that through the hip. So all of this here, all this here is staying as it is. All of our adjustments are going to be in here and in here. One of the first things which I did was come in and to figure out the angle for the front waist, because it's going to be lower than the back waistline, squared off against the outseam here and drew in a line here, which is this line, and then decided how much I wanted to drop the front waist by, which in this case is going to be about 1 7/8 inches, and squared off against that line from the center front. So we've got these two lines intersect, and that gives me a good idea of about where I'm going to be sketching my new waistline. So I know I want to keep everything north of this line as I come through here like this. That looks good. I'll just put this in the marker so you can see more clearly. And that's going to be the new top of the waistline. I'll come in and fill in this line here for you as well so you can see better on the camera where that's going. Now, the next thing which I want to do is figure out how I'm going to reshape the front crotch shaping, because obviously we have a fly flap on here, my sort of signature closure method on the steeplejacks. So if I bring these out, there we go, steeplejacks. For this to work, it requires that the seams in here be running parallel to each other, so I have to have it completely straight through the length of this. Now, as our crotch seam isn't so low, and this one's being styled for a lady, we don't need to have this quite so long, so I have to decide about how long I want to run with that. I'm going to go from our front waistline probably down about 6 inches or so. And so I want to see, this line here is showing me where my seam allowance for the top waist is. And let's see, one there to 6 inches. This here is the seam allowance off the front. So that would mean that I would need to keep it straight through to here. I'm going to be reshaping the line of the crotch in like that. So that pretty much decides that. I'm actually going to go ahead and shorten up just a little bit more because I want to add a little bit more easing in the front, and I can do that better when coming up there. And I can probably cheat it for the last 1/2 inch or so, and it's not going to be a problem with keeping this line pretty straight. So that being the case, I feel pretty confident I have my new front line here. And I can go ahead and mark that in. Next stage is going to be working out a rough shape of what I want the front fly flap to be. I'm going to alter that ever so slightly, and tracing out the rest of the legs. So I'll go ahead and do that, and we'll be back in a minute.
Okay, so we've traced around the outside of the pattern, and we have the shaping for the new fly facing in here. This here is going to be the line upon which it mirrors, and we'll be tracing that out onto a separate piece of paper in just a minute. Next thing to do is go ahead and bring in the old thigh panel, and we're going to be matching that up to the original waistline. Should be there-ish. And then figuring out how we want to reshape this so it fits on with the current leg, you know, shorting up a little bit. Figuring out exactly where the pocket's gonna run. We'll be tracing the pocket bag onto this afterwards and then tracing all of these pieces back off of the pattern. No people on here, just pieces of paper.
Alright, so I've got all of the tracing on the front panel done. You have a look here, I'll show you exactly what we've patterned out. So you've already seen the outline for the fly flap. Now we have the new thigh panel. So obviously built roughly off of this just to get the width and stuff like that, rough positioning of it. Moved this line here down and adjusted it a little bit, moved the whole thing up lengthwise. So you can see that traced out here. And then I've also gone and adjusted and traced out the pocket pattern on it. So now I'm going to go ahead, trace out these ones, add the seam allowances in on separate pieces of paper and cut those out. And then we'll come back and cut out the main leg. And then it's just the calves and the waistband that we have left to do. Simple as that. Okay, so here we go. We've now got all of our front panels figured out here. We've got the front leg panel, we've got the thigh panel, we've got our pocket bag, and we've got the fly flap all traced out from all of our marking on here. Next thing to do is we're going to make the waistband. And we're going to make the new belt loops for the whole arrangement. So this is when the set of tracings which I have here come in handy. That actually matches up to there. You can't see the end of the way through. But now what I need to do is go ahead and start connecting all these pieces of the waistband together. We'll draft the waistband, and then we're going to use these here as templates upon which to create the shape of the new belt loops, because I think we're going to go with something a little different on the belt loop design. So I'm going to go ahead and trace out the waistband now, and then we'll come back and take a look at that and get on with the belt loops. So, as you can see, one of the inherent risks in pattern making while drinking is the potential for spilling one's beverage, and this is a terrible thing when you're working on stuff made out of paper and such. And luckily we don't have any fabric on the table. It's a very good reason why you should never drink while pattern drafting, or cutting for that matter. However, not to fear, I have another beer. So it's okay, it wasn't my last one. I'm going to show you what I'm doing with the waistband pattern here now. This here is the back half of it and the front half of it traced. And usually with the steeplejacks, what we do is we do it as a single piece waistband like this, which is a contoured waistband. With this one here, because of the revisions I've done to the pattern, adjusting the hip and stuff like that, we've now got so much curve into it. I could straighten out a little bit so I could cut it as one piece, but what I'm going to do is I'm going to do a split waistband in the back, and I actually may go back and revise the center back seam on the steeplejacks themselves so that if necessary we could let them out for the client at a later date. But we're going to do it, so we're just going to split it in the back and have a two-piece waistband rather than a one-piece waistband. And that's going to allow us to do a couple of things. One of the issues that the client had was that when she sat down too quickly with the steeplejacks, she found that they tended to pop a snap in front and she'd have to snap that back up again. Not a huge problem, but, you know, not quite ideal. So by having this much curve worked into it, what I can do is I can set the grain line on it. Bring the camera back down here. I can set the grain line on it, so if I run it through here, or if I run it through here, or if I run it through here at this angle, depending on how I lay out on the fabric, I can control which part of it's straight cut and won't stretch, and which part of it's going to be somewhat on the bias and can add a bit of stretch into it. So I'll probably cut a couple of pieces just from some scrap cloth and have an experiment on how it stretches before I decide exactly how I want to set the grain line on this one. But most likely I'll have the grain line coming straight through the back here, which is going to put a little bit of bias cut into the front, and that's going to allow a little bit of stretch there and take a little bit of pressure off of the snaps when our client sits down. So hopefully that'll work out nicely, and there we go. So here are the final two pieces of the pattern which we got done. Just the calf panel and the little flap that the snaps go on for closing it up. It's pretty simple, basically. You know, obviously the only thing you're doing is matching this width here to the bottom of the leg and matching this width here to your customer's ankle measurement. And the height is already established at 14 inches, so that's all pretty self-explanatory. Anyone should be able to draw something like that. And go ahead and cut it out, and then we'll be able to do a quick review over the whole pattern, and we will be done at that point. Alright, so here we go. We have the completed pattern. Just in quick review, here's the back leg panel from which everything started. We've got our back yoke right here, waistband, belt loops, pocket bag. Here's the front leg panel with the thigh reinforcement there. There's the thigh flap, calf panel, and a little snap inset panel for the calves. And that's pretty much it. We will be sticking a pair of cargo pockets on this pattern for the customer, but as I already have a pattern for that, I'm not going to bother redrafting it, and if you guys can't draft a pattern for a cargo pocket, then frankly, this tutorial isn't going to help you anyway. So, with that being said, all that remains is me to go back in and finish my beer, and then we'll see about cutting this and sewing it later. Cheers!